Premiere gal, what is in your hands?
This is my expert kid palette gear.
What is it for?
Well, I use it to control colors in Premiere Pro for when I video edit.
But it's also for Photoshop, right?
Yeah, you can use it with any software.
Great! Can you unbox it for us?
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna show you how to set it up and use it with Premiere Pro, coming up in this What Wednesday video. So let's open up the expert kit. All right, so as you see here, there are three knobs, two buttons, two sliders, and a brain which connects and controls all of these. And I'll show you how to set that up in a second. But first, you need to connect the brain via USB to the computer. And the really cool thing to also note is that on the bottom of each of these buttons and sliders is a rubber mat, so that way it doesn't slide on your desktop. And on the side of all of these are these golden prongs here, and the brain doesn't have a male input, but if you notice on all of the other ones are these prongs here, the male input, which connects it to the female input, okay? And that's how you connect them. So let's first connect the brain via the USB cord that it comes with. So just connect this here like so, and then we will put the other end in the computer. And before we do that, let's just go ahead and set all of these on the desk to put them together. All right, so let's connect the brain to the computer first. All right. So see how they just sort of all connected together? That's because they have magnets, but you have to be careful because they need to be connected in a particular way. As I showed you just briefly before, each of them has a male input except for the brain. So they have these male prongs. And to connect it to each other, you need to put the male prongs into the female prongs, like so. And you can connect it in any way that you like. Any direction, like I could take this and put it here if I wanted to, I could put it here, anyway, but I'm putting it in the fashion that I like, so I'm putting it like this, I'll put the buttons up here, and they connect together, and once they're connected, they light up, and that means that they're active. And same with here, I'll find the prongs, connect it here, and you can put them anywhere that you want, you could put it here, but I like it here. So I like to place my palette gear to the left of my Logic keyboard, and I'm right-handed, so I like to actually have my mouse in my right hand because I still need to click occasionally when I use the palette, and then I can use the palette with my left hand like so. All right, so let's go ahead and jump in and I'll show you how to install the palette app. All right, so before I show you how to use palette in Premiere Pro, go to palettegear.com and be sure to download the app for your computer. They have palette for Mac or palette for Windows. So I've already installed it, and what I did was actually open up Premiere Pro first, and you can see I have this ocean stock video here, which I'll show you how to color correct and grade using palette. So now go and open up the palette app, so you can see that this configuration I have is exactly modeling what I have physically here on my desk. And if I change any of these here, you can see that it moves on the screen too, which is pretty cool. So I'll put that back because I like it here. And so I started with just a loaded preset that they had. If you click on this add button here, there's different profiles for a bunch of different apps, from Adobe apps, even Final Cut Pro X, regular apps like Google Chrome, Spotify, iTunes, a whole bunch, right? So I started by clicking on Premiere Pro and it brought up this one here. And if you double click on any of these, you can assign it a new value. So if I wanted to change temperature here to exposure, I just double click and then I search for exposure. And then I just click on exposure and it updates to exposure, right? So you can do that to any one of these. So now that it's active, and make sure it says connected here. If it says disconnected, it will not work with Premiere Pro. To get it connected, just make sure that the USB is plugged in. So now let's go back in Premiere Pro, and you have to remember your values, of course, because it's not written here on your physical palette. So I just need to remember that the top one is exposure, below that is vibrance, then contrast, and then Lumetri panel here just opens up the Lumetri panel. This resets it if I ever need to, you know, say scratch this, I don't like what I'm doing, I'll just reset it. And then this controls the blacks and the whites down here, okay? So let's go into Premiere Pro and show it in action. So right now the Lumetri color is selected. If I was not in the Lumetri color panel, let's say I was over here in the scopes, if I hit this button, it will take me to the Lumetri color panel, which is pretty cool. And right now I want to reset it, so I'm just going to click this button and it will reset all of the values, so I don't have to go in physically with my mouse and control all of these, right? So it's less clicking. So let's say we wanted to play with the exposure here, I would just turn the exposure knob and automatically you can see that the exposure is raised, right? And if I wanted to adjust the contrast, which is this knob down here, I could adjust the contrast like so. And you can also control the limit. So right now I have mine set at 25. I can't go above 25 contrast. And that's something that you can change in the palette app. So if I was gonna double click on contrast and go under advanced, you see I set the range to be minus 25 or 25. And you can set that to 100, 50, any number in between negative 100 and 100, okay? I just wanted to make sure that you understand that you can adjust the sensitivity with how quickly things move. This is sensitivity, how quickly the knob moves, and the range, a limit to how far you can go and how less you can go in a particular effect. So let's go back. So I'm liking the contrast here at 25. Let's adjust, and I like to use the Lumetri scopes up here. So right now it's almost at 100, which is good, but we need to bring it down closer to 0 to have more contrast. So let's actually adjust the blacks here. So let's bring the blacks down. See how the blacks are moving down in Lumetri? And now it just looks a lot richer. And I love that I'm controlling it physically because it gives me more precision, okay? And I also have a vibrancy here. If I twist the vibrancy knob, you can see that the creative tab automatically opened up and I can just increase the vibrancy a bit to make it a little bit more bright. And vibrancy is so much better than saturation because it only makes the part of the image that is not as saturated more saturated. And saturation makes everything more saturated. So right now I'm liking this image. If we wanted to see what it looked like before and after, we could of course use the mouse to go to effects and just click this on and off. So you can see I just made it, you know, far more intense. I may want to tone down the brightness just a little bit. So I'll just go back up here and tone down the brightness a little bit. And there it's looking pretty good. So that's really all there is to it. You can also go back to the palette app. And if you wanted to share this profile, you could actually save the profile to your desktop. So I named one Gal's Color Grade, so I'll just copy this over and hit save. And I'll actually link to this palette profile and share it with you guys. And you can also share it to palette and it will appear at palettegear.com/profiles. There is also, if you double click on this, you can change the name that you see here. So if I wanted to call it Gal's Grade, I could do that and just hit done. You can also change the colors here. So if you wanted it to be, let's say green, you can double click and change it to be this greenish color. And you can do that for every single one. You can assign a color and they will change color on the screen. So if I wanted this to be purple, I would say done. If I wanted the vibrancy to be orange, I could hit done. If I wanted the contrast to be blue, it would also change color here. And if I wanted to change this red, let's say to a bright green, it would change. Now let's change this to a yellow. And now we have all sorts of colors. And this is great for people that have more of color cognition, people that are associating with colors with learning. You can say, okay, exposure is purple, orange is vibrance, contrast is blue, and so on. And so now you have these different color values, which is pretty cool. I also wanted to show you that there's also different profiles preloaded. So if we wanted to add a new one here, you could look at these different profiles here and you can select, you know, Premiere Pro here, and down below you can select on the quick start profile. So they actually have an edit one. So if you hit edit, it automatically assigns these edit controls. So for example, zoom in and out on the timeline, jog through the timeline, go to an edit point, play, stop, opacity, and scale. So for example, if we go back in Premiere Pro now and we're on the edit, you know, if I wanted to scale this up, I could use this slider here just to scale, right? And here I could go and zoom in and out of the timeline. If I'm in the timeline, you can zoom in and out like so, and you can click play and stop, and you could jog, which means just scrubbing through the timeline, and this one will go to the next edit point really quickly, which is super useful. All right, so that concludes our Palette Gear What Wednesday video. I hope that you guys found it useful. If you have any questions about Palette, be sure to leave a comment below. The Palette team is also super awesome and supportive. So I'd encourage you guys to go check out their website. I'll leave a link in the description box below. So that's it, and if you guys are still here, we're now in the end screen of the YouTube video, so you can click anywhere on the screen to subscribe to my channel or any other video tutorials to learn something new. Thanks again, you guys. I appreciate your support, and I'll see you all for Friday Effects tutorial. Bye.